Hey guys, and welcome to my channel, Davina's Faith. It's Davina here. So today I'm going to be sharing my testimony. So I already shared my testimony on my channel, but I kind of have what brought me closer to God. I have that video that talks about my testimony, and I have a few other videos where I mention some parts of my testimony in the video. But today I'm going to be sharing my testimony thus far, like where I've been from and where I am now. Still a work in progress, so you guys know that none of us are perfect, and you know God's still working on me. But I'm just going to share my testimony thus far, like what God brought me through, all that stuff. So this is my testimony, you guys. Trying to look in the right place, as always. I never know where to look. Sometimes I feel like I'm looking in the lens, and then it's like I'm not looking in the camera when I do look in the lens sometimes. So sorry if my eyes are going all over the place. I'm just trying to make sure that I'm giving you guys some type of eye contact here and there. I grew up in a big family. Like, I came from a large household. So I guess I could start from before my dad passed away. So my mom and dad, they were married. She had one kid before she met my dad, and they got married. So my older brother, and that's the brother that passed away, Emmanuel, he was born before my mom and dad got married. Then they got married, and then I was next. So I guess I was a honeymoon baby, because I came shortly after. I came 9 months after they got married. I believe they got married sometime in March, and I was born in December. So I'm pretty much like a honeymoon baby. And then my mom had my other siblings, and my father, he passed away when I was 6 years old, going on 7. And during that time, my mom and dad were in church. Like, they met when they were really young. My dad was older than my mom, but they're both young. I can't remember how much older, maybe 4 or 5 years older. My mom was 20. Yeah, she was 20 when they got married, and 21 when she had me. Her birthday's in November, so right before my birthday. And I think my dad was like 25 years old. I can't remember. So he ended up passing away from illness shortly after. Like, they were married up until he passed away. And I believe if he was still alive, they would still be married. So after he passed away, you know, we were a big family, and we struggled. So I come from a poor household now. Everybody that's in my family line isn't from poverty, you know. I have family members that, you know, have a pretty good living, whatever. And some of us, we struggle as well. And then in my immediate family, like coming from my mom, after my dad passed away, we struggled. I don't know how it was when he was still alive. They weren't like well off. I know that, but I'm pretty sure they had a decent life, or we had a decent life. But you know, my mom, she had ended up having more children, two more children, and she didn't get married until years and years later after that happened. And we struggled. So I grew up poor, but I grew up in the church. That's one thing I want to mention. When they met, they were in the church. I'm not sure if my mother went back to church after she met my dad, but they brung us up in church. So I knew who God was. Like, I knew about Jesus. I didn't understand everything, because you just go based on what they say in church. I don't remember personally having any just sit down talks about God and Jesus just in the house until I got a little bit older, like when I was like a teenager. Then my mom started to tell me a little bit more, and then of course as I got older, I started studying for myself. But it took me years to really study for myself. But I would just go, you know, by what I can remember in church. Like, sometimes, you know, you're a kid, you'll start dazing off, or you'll start giggling with the person that you're sitting next to. You know, a lot of times I didn't understand everything about God or whatever, but I knew that there was a God. I knew who God was, and I knew about Jesus Christ. And I just always knew that God was real, because I just had that feeling. Some people, they just have like an unction, like you just know that you know that you know. That was me. So yeah, we grew up poor, whatever. I don't know if I'm gonna go into full detail about this, because I'm trying not to make the video long. I have other videos up here that I need to edit. But yeah, grew up poor. Just a poor household. I don't want to just keep on saying poor, but we did. We had lots of good times. I had fun childhood, for the most part. Grew up pretty shy, quiet, introverted child. Me and one of my siblings and I, we didn't get along, so we would get into it a lot. My brother that came right after me, we would get into it a lot. We were a year apart. But we always had a lot of fun together, playing in the house, making clubhouses, making fake roller coasters with the parts to the bunk bed. We had bunk beds, so I had to share a room with my brothers because, I had brothers at first. I do have two older sisters, but they're from my dad's side. My dad had two kids before he met my mom, so we never lived together. And my sisters didn't come right along. Right away. They came like well after me. My sister from my mom and my dad, or just that came from my mom. She is 6 years older than me, so I just grew up with brothers at first. After me, it was my brother. Then I had another brother, and then I had the older brother. So it was always me and the boys. And then my little sister, she was just like a little baby. So I had to share a room with the boys or whatever. We had bunk beds. I remember that, bunk beds. And we would make those roller coasters. We had a lot of fun together. When our cousins would come over, we would play together, have fun, have adventures, play outside. I had a pretty good childhood, regardless of being poor. There was times where my mom, she, had a good amount of money, and she always made sure we had it, like we had food in the house. When she got extra money, we would go shopping together, all that stuff. So I had a pretty good childhood, regardless of me being poor, experiencing poverty. When you're a kid, you don't really know that you're in poverty. You could tell that you're a little poor, but you don't see it how you see it when you get older. And a lot of, since I grew up that way, you live in poorer neighborhoods, so the people that surround you, they're poor too. So it's not like you're really comparing yourself to each other until you get older. Until you get older, and then you meet other people that didn't come from that, then you might question some things. So then, when I was about 11, I got saved, and I got saved at a church. We were fellowshipping with somebody else. I don't know. No. My pastor didn't preach, but we went to support a famous, not famous, a well-known preacher that we fellowship with. And she was a speaker, and she helped me to get saved, basically. I was never outgoing in church. Like, I would never, I would sing here and there, like go up in front of church and sing, but I was just very quiet. I barely clapped my hands. I definitely didn't shout. I'll clap my hands here and there. So I wasn't really involved in church besides, occasionally singing. Then, once I hit like preteens, I would sing in the choir. So I wasn't that much involved with church. But when she had spoke, she asked me a question or whatever, and she tried to, help me to learn to praise God or whatever. And from then, I got saved. So, okay, I was about 11 years old when that happened, when I got saved. And then I'm going to my teen years. Of course, I'm still with God or whatever, but I'm not outrightly serving God. I'm not making any dedications. I'm not telling people about God. And yeah, I'm just living a regular teenage life. I'm just trying to be cute. Not doing anything bad. I was a virgin in high school. But like, I was very into fashion, so I always looked cute. Like, my outfits were cute. I had long, straight, dark hair. So that was my signature look. I did not wear natural hair at all. I just had the long, straight hair. I was just so into my looks or whatever. Other people thought I was pretty as well. It was kind of awkward for me too, because I was quiet and shy. So some people, they liked me and thought I was, a nice looking young lady. But some people may have thought I was weird or whatever. Like, oh, she kind of cute, but she's a little weird because, she don't do this, she don't do that. She's quiet, she's still herself. And when I got to high school, I started to interact a little bit more with people, but I was still introverted. And then I go to college. I'm still a bit that way, but I have my best friend with me. As we went to community college together. I'm still a virgin at this time, and I didn't make any dedication to stay a virgin or anything. I didn't decide for myself. Like, people told me, like, oh, girl, it's so good that you're still a virgin. Like, people that are older than me tell me that, you know, they like that I'm still a virgin. In high school, it was good if you were still a virgin. If you was, like, a junior and maybe a senior, like, people give you your props, like, oh, yeah, she's still a virgin. Guys would like that, you know, if you were still a virgin. Of course, there were girls that were having sex already, and even kids in middle school that were already having sex, but you did get some respect if you were still a virgin, if you was, like, a junior, and sometimes a senior. People like that, guys like that. But then once I got to college, it was a little tough. All guys didn't like that. So I didn't have the best of luck with dating, and I was on the fence on if I should be a virgin or not. Like, should I stay a virgin? The only reason why at that point I was still a virgin was because I didn't find anybody that I really wanted to go that route with, you know. I didn't make a dedication to God that I wanted to be a virgin. I didn't decide in my mind or decide for myself that I wanted to remain a virgin until I got married. So I eventually lost that virginity. I stayed a virgin past 21 years old. So I was an adult virgin. I do have the experience of being an adult virgin. So if you guys want to know more about my experience of being an adult virgin, leave it down below. I'm no longer a virgin, but I did make it up to my adulthood with being a virgin, so I do know how it feels to be a virgin as a young adult. So since I wasn't secure in that, I didn't know if I wanted to remain a virgin or whatever. Regardless, what everybody told me, what my mom said, how my brother protected me, what other people said, that it's such a good thing. Wasn't sure for myself if I wanted to be a virgin, so I ended up, you know, just making that decision to have sex or whatever. And, you know, it wasn't special, to be honest. Like, it wasn't with somebody that I was in love with or that I was with for a long time, but I ended up doing it because I wasn't sure. And I was just tired of being a virgin, to be honest. I'm just gonna be honest with y'all. And then, so after the losing the virginity thing came, you know, I was becoming sexually active. I didn't go too crazy, but I guess I kept on having sex for a while. And then at a certain point, I decided to stop or whatever. Like, okay, I'm tired of this. I'm not getting any good results from just doing this or whatever. I want something better for myself. I want, you know, a committed relationship with someone. Sorry if you guys hear like noise outside. I'm in my shop, and I decided to film this video before I leave out, so it's like during the daytime, people are gonna go by. So yeah, I decided that, you know what, I'm going to rededicate myself to God, and I'm going to become celibate. This was the very first time that I did it. So I was like, yeah, you know, I'm not going to have sex or whatever. So I had tried to stop talking to the guy that I was talking to, whatever, because he, even though we were like seeing each other for a while, he just wasn't serious like he should have been. And I found out that he was talking to other people as well. Somebody had texted my phone. So I had did that for a while, but I ended up talking to him again, so messed up again. After that, I had started to be more involved. Like, I had found Heather Lindsay, and she was the person that made me, I think the first time, yeah, she was the one that made me want to be celibate, whatever. I had got her t-shirt, one of her t-shirts that she was selling, my Adam is Sleeping. I had the promise ring for myself. I would wear it on my ring finger, and I had got one of her books. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna do this or whatever. So I was doing that. Then I ended up falling again, picked myself back up, whatever, not seeing anybody. Then I had met the person that I had ended up getting engaged to, whatever. Everything was cool. We talked about being celibate, everything. So we were celibate throughout the relationship. But then things had happened or whatever. And once we got engaged, we ended up falling or whatever. And, you know, I still try to encourage him, like, you know, we should stop or whatever. And I had a book that someone gave me, and we were trying to read together. I tried to have him to read the book with me, but I was more interested than he was. But when we first got into the relationship, we both made the commitment to, or at least he said that he was committed to being celibate, but I was. And I ended up falling again because I thought that, I can't just say just because, but I did think that he was going to be my husband. I felt like I had saw all the signs that he was the one. And, you know, sometimes you just get caught up or whatever, and you get comfortable. And I just thought, like, okay, he's gonna be the one, so you know, it'll be okay, you know, we could just, you know, whatever, we do it and then we just stop or whatever, and we're gonna be married anyway. But that didn't work out, whatever. We ended up breaking up. So I have to add this in. I don't really want to, like, I hate to have to say this stuff, but I have to add it in because it is my testimony, and this is how I started to come to where I am now. If this, I can't say if this stuff didn't happen, but this is the things that made me come back to God. So after that didn't work out, whatever, I got even closer to God. My brother had ended up passing away shortly after we broke up. And yeah, I had just got closer to God. I was like, I know God not playing with me. And somebody had already prophesied to me before we broke up, and before, and they probably prophesied right after we had the slip up or whatever. You know, like, God wants somebody that's gonna really serve him. And all the person was that I had just got engaged, which was true, whatever. So, and they told me that I was gonna go through, that I was gonna struggle and stuff. So, like, I was gonna have a hard season. And I did end up having that. We broke up, I couldn't find a place when I was trying to get a place, all this stuff. A lot of things that happens that are going good for me now was the things that I was trying to get to during that time, and all the doors had closed for me. And then shortly after, my brother had passed away. So I was very, very hurt, like, going through the pain of a breakup and then going through the pain of losing my closest brother, the brother that I felt was the closest to me. It really hurt. So, yeah, I had really got really, really, really serious about God, trying to do right by God and just wanting to learn more of my word for myself. And I just started to like look up dreams, because I later found out that my sister had a dream, but it wasn't like the same, it wasn't my brother in the dream, it was somebody else. But I later knew that that was in reference to my brother, that he was gonna pass away. And something else happened that made me start wanting to look at my dreams. Oh, I had a client from my aunt. My aunt referred somebody to me, I found someone, but she knew my aunt. My aunt is a pastor, and she became a client of mine. She would get her hair braided here and there. She had posted something on Facebook about a dream course, a dream interpretation course. So, and it wasn't a lot of money. It probably was like $35, something like that. So I decided to take it. I was like, you know what? I always had dreams all my life. My family always asked me about dreams, and when they would ask me, I didn't know anything about dreams during that time. I kind of had a little bit of a gist for it. I didn't know anything about dreams. So I'm like, my family always asked me about dreams, and I'm always having dreams. My dreams came to pass, and I want to understand my dreams. So more about when I have like those tricky dreams, so let me sign up for this. So I signed up for it, did the course. Then I started to find other people as well. So she was the beginning. She was the first person that brought me to dream interpretation. Her name is Shaquanda. I can't remember her last name. Shaquanda. And then I found other people. Found out that Perry Stone was into dreams too. I didn't know that. I found some other people. Barbie Breathitt, Dr. Faith, Wacoma, and John Paul Jackson, and some other, and Tamar McNair, the people that helped me the most, like, to really go deeper, not to compare anybody, was John Paul Jackson and Tamara McNair. So I found Tamara McNair Hicks after I found John Paul Jackson, and it was so devastating that when I found John Paul Jackson that he passed away, because, you know, I really wanted to, like, you know, I would have loved to met him, or and to buy some of his books. I'm pretty sure I could still buy some of his books, but, you know, I was just like, man, this guy passed away. I loved watching his miniseries shows. They have it on YouTube here, so you guys can check that out too. And they still actually make videos, the people that his network or whatever. But yeah, his videos were the best though. And I love his series, how he makes it like a mystery. I love watching him. And he was a nice looking man too, you know? He ended up passing away from cancer. And I could see, I was looking at his neck before I found out that he passed away, and I noticed that it was like dented. I'm like, what's up with his neck? Like, he's a very nice looking older man, but what's up with his neck? And once I found that he passed away, I found out that he passed away from cancer, from lung cancer, I believe. So yeah, let me stop rambling. But yeah, so that's how I got into dream interpretation. So before I get into that, I ended up going to start staying with my mom in PA. I was didn't move there with her yet, but I started coming there on the weekends. When I didn't have client, I would travel back and forth from Jersey to PA because I still was working at the shop that was working there in New Jersey. I still had clients out there. And this is when I started to learn to hear God's voice. So I just had this unction that a young lady on the bus was going to ask me to use my phone or was going to talk to me or going to need my help in some type of way. Somebody was going to ask me if I need help when I was walking down the street going to my mom's house because I took the bus there. I took not the Greyhound, but it's another like bus that you could take from New Jersey to PA. I took that bus and something else was going to happen. It was three things. And sure enough, those three things happened. When I was on the bus to go to PA, a young lady with a baby asked me, can she use my phone before she got off the bus? And then when I got off the bus and then I was traveling to my mom's house, I was walking, a car with people asked me, it was guys, they weren't trying to flirt with me though. They asked me if I needed help and something else happened, I can't remember it. So from then on, that's when I started to hear God. I always heard from God in my dreams. I just didn't understand all of them, but before that time happened, and I was 25 or 26, before that time had happened, I never heard God like you could hear through your ears. Like it's not like you hear it exactly audible, but it's just like you hear him in your spirit and you hear him through your ears. I could just see. I was a seer and a filler, but then I started to learn how to actually hear God. So I started reading my word more and more. So I'll be at my grandmother's house in New Jersey reading my Bible. She was getting scared because I would have the TV off and just reading my Bible and writing down notes. She didn't know what was going on. She thought I was going through something or whatever. But I had to assure her that, you know, I'm not going crazy. I'm not suicidal. I'm not any of that. I'm just learning my word and I'm learning to hear from God. You know, I didn't say it like that, but I'm like, I'm okay. I'm just reading my Bible. So during that time, I really, really started to hear God super crisp, super clear. And God started showing me more and more dreams. So he would show me dreams about myself. He would show me dreams about the people that was around me to help them or whatever. So everything was being so clear during that time. So it was beautiful. So I eventually moved to Ohio with my parents, with my mom and my family. I moved there with them. They convinced me to. So I ended up never getting my place like I was trying to get before my brother passed away. After my brother passed away, we just all needed comfort. We all needed each other. So I ended up moving back with my mom. And and plus all those doors had closed down. I couldn't get a place to save my life. So I had no other choice really. So I ended up moving back with my mom. Then we moved to from where she was been living in PA for some years. I believe, and then we moved to Ohio together. And then from then on, I started working like odd jobs. I would do hair, like it was hard for me to find clients because I'm new, but when I first came there, I did like some odd jobs. And you know, I'll tell people about God while I was there, whatever, and not just coming up to them like, do you know Jesus Christ? You know, we'll just be talking like as a group, and then something would happen where God would come up in the topic or in the conversation, and then I would start talking about God with them. So all the little jobs that I had in from PA to Ohio, even PA to New Jersey, because I had some 9-to-5 jobs here too before I started working in the shop, I was telling people about God. I even tell people about God here, like if the conversation goes to it, everybody knows that I'm a Christian. They hear me play Christian music and I'm not afraid to tell my faith. So yeah. All that happened. So yeah, did I even tell you guys? Okay, so after me and the fiance that I had, after we broke up, I made the decision once again to be celibate. And I have been practicing abstinence ever since or whatever. So yeah, I had made that decision to do that again, once again. And then all the stuff happened. I ended up moving, like visiting PA and traveling back and forth from PA to New Jersey. Then I moved to Ohio. And then, of course, God, after about 2 years, maybe, I don't know, 2 or 3 years, I actually had a boyfriend too in PA, and God showed me that that boyfriend wasn't the one. Maybe I'll do a separate video on that. So he was a Christian and everything, but he was a Seventh Day Adventist, so you know that's a little different. They like to do things a little differently than the average Christian does. And God has shown me that he wasn't the one for me, so it was hard to do it because I didn't really have anything against him, but I kept feeling it in my spirit and God kept on showing me dreams. So I ended up breaking up with him before I moved to Ohio. So now I'm in Ohio. I'm not dating anyone. I did give like a few guys a chance here and there, let them take me, like I'll talk to a few guys to be honest. But yeah, I, you know, was just living for God. And then God showed me that I should come here. So if you want to know more about that story of how God told me, when he told me, all that stuff, I'll try to link all the videos that I'm talking about in the description so you guys can check it out. So yeah, God ended up telling me that I should move to New Jersey through dreams. And I ended up moving to New Jersey and I've been here for over 2 years now. I am currently still living with my grandmother, which is kind of weird for me. I would love to be in my own place, but you know, I'm still getting things together. I'm still bringing up my credit. I applied to plenty of apartments and it didn't come through at this moment yet because of my credit. So I make enough money to afford a pretty decent apartment on my own, but I don't have good credit, so I'm building up my credit, and I'm just believing that God's going to show me, you know, a place. Like, I'm believing God that he's going to give me a place. I know he will. So I am at 30 years old living with my grandmother. It's like crazy, but you know, I know my grandmother appreciates it to have somebody there. It doesn't feel good all the time, you know. Sometimes I'm like, man, God, I should be having my own place right now. Then sometimes I would think, like, you know, I'm coming home to my grandmother when this is the time that I should be coming home to a family, like a family of my own, like a husband and kids, or at least at least a husband. And I don't have any of that. I come home to my grandmother every night, and you know, but I just have to stay strong. It's not easy. I'm still like trying to, you know, keep on going through the journey, not give up, and just, you know, just keep on doing the right thing. It's not easy to do the right thing, to be honest. But yeah, so that's my journey, that's my testimony. So through all of that, it brought me all the trials and tribulations. I didn't tell everything, but I just gave you a gist of it. It brought me closer to God. I grew up as a teenager onto adulthood not being a confident virgin. There's some virgins that are very confident in being a virgin. They're happy to be a virgin. They want the whole world to know, but I wasn't like that. I wasn't hiding it. If people would ask me, I would tell them, but I wasn't flaunting it, and I wasn't certain if I wanted to remain a virgin until marriage. So yeah, I was the one that wasn't confident in that. I grew up hating being skinny. I hated being skinny. I was skinny. I was teased a bit for being skinny, for having smaller breasts. I grew up, like most people thought I was a nice looking young lady. Like I said, not to be cocky or conceited, but lots of people did think I was beautiful or pretty. But I did have some things where I didn't feel good about, like I hated being skinny, and then people tease me about something that I didn't like, and then people also tease me about other things. Like I said, I have a smaller breast or whatever. People, a smaller bust area, people tease me about that. They tease me about having this hairline. That is my story, that is my testimony, that is my journey. There is more, but I'm not, you know, I can't go through every last thing that ever happened into my life. It's just like, when you touch on a certain topic, you could go more into one thing that you went through. But that is the things that I went through, and that is what brought me closer to God. That is why I am still walking with God. That is why I'm here. And I also told you guys about how I started dream interpretation. It wasn't something that I always did, and it wasn't something that I would just naturally had. I had to develop it. Some of it is natural, but you know, I did have to develop it. I did have to go through training. I didn't go through training in my church, but I did learn through the course that I took and reading books. I read several books So I read, I did her course. I did read a book from John Paul Jackson. I found out about John Paul Jackson from a book that I read that I found at the library when I first went to Ohio. So when I first went to Ohio, we didn't have cable at first. We had to wait. Of course, when you first move somewhere, you have to wait for them to install the cable. So it was still that stage. We were waiting for the cable to be installed. And yeah, I found the library, went there, and I found some spiritual books. So I found Christian books. So it was a Christian book about dream interpretation, crazy enough. And it was by, I think I have, I'll link the video in the description. R.L. Lawrence, something like that was the artist's name. And then, like the introduction or something was written by John Paul Jackson. So I had just decided to look him up because he approved of him. Like, yeah, I really approve of him with dream interpretation. Found John Paul Jackson, and I also found a book in my brother's belongings. It wasn't about dreams, but it was about a young lady. A woman had wrote her book about finding your Boaz or whatever. I found that book too in my brother's stuff. So I read many books, a good amount of books during that time after the breakup. The breakup is what really made me really, really serious about God. I thought I was serious about God before then. Once I hit like 24 years old, but after the breakup was when I really got serious about God. So yeah, I had just started to study a lot, and God started to show me dreams, and then I would start interpreting people's dreams on YouTube. And when I say on YouTube, I don't mean on this channel. I mean like people would start talking about their dreams in their videos, just filming a regular video, posting a regular video. Then they would say something about a dream, and then I would like interpret their dream for them. I'll see people talking about their dream in a comment, and then I would comment underneath. And it wasn't even this channel; it was my other channel, my hair channel, that I would comment interpreting their dreams. So I just started getting really, really good at it during that time once I started to grow. And then I started to talk about dreams on this channel here and there. I was just trying to find my niche. So I would do a lot of Dollar Tree videos because I loved Dollar Tree. I still love Dollar Tree, but I would go to Dollar Tree all the time. So I thought that was gonna be the things that would make me grow and that people would come to me for. It did bring some people, but I wasn't consistent enough, so I would do Dollar Tree videos, some little product review videos, whatever I felt was cool or fun, I would do those. But I would do dream interpretation videos here and there, and then I stopped, and then I started doing the DoorDash videos and the vlogs and stuff, and the computer help videos. I guess you can say that, the electronic help videos. And then I started to touch back on dreams. I was like, you know what, I want to talk about dreams again. And I started to film dream videos again, and then the rest is history. I'm here. I know I'm not like big or anything, but I'm here. I grew from only having less than 100 subscribers, like 80 something subscribers, so now I'm in the 500. So that's a blessing. It's taken me years to get to where people only would take like a year to get or less, but I come from a long way. I'll say that, and God's growing me, and I'm grateful. I'm happy for where I am now, and I do enjoy doing these videos. It took a lot for me to even start doing these videos. I didn't even start these videos, start this channel to do. Like I said, I didn't start out doing dream videos or dream interpretation videos. I actually started this channel for to promote myself with hair because I am a cosmetologist. I am a hairstylist. Before I had made my other channel, I had started this one for hair. So I told the people, that I work with, and then some people on my Facebook page, to subscribe to this channel so they could watch me, and it was for me to promote hair. But I ended up doing other things, and now I do dream interpretation on this channel, and talk about God. I do faith-based videos on this channel, and that wasn't the intention. But all along with me doing YouTube, it helped me to bring out a lot of confidence. I'm now a more confident speaker. I'm not perfect. Like, I'm not really like a good speaker. I say a lot. I stutter sometimes. I have a lisp. I don't know if you guys notice it, but I have it's not that bad, but I do have a slight lisp. All that. So I'm not the best speaker, but with God, bring me here. It developed me into a better speaker. And now I come on here confidently speaking to you guys. I was so shy to be on like YouTube. I did make a channel years and years ago when I first went natural, trying to show my hair journey. But then once my family found out about it, because I left some videos on a computer and they watched it, I got so embarrassed that I stopped making the videos because I was like, oh my God, they saw it. I just wanted people that didn't know me from a can of paint to find those videos, not people that I knew. So once people that I knew found those videos, I was just so like, I was embarrassed, so I stopped. But God brought me back here on YouTube, and now I'm talking about God. I'm honoring God with my YouTube channel. It's not easy, like I said. So yeah, I'm here. I ask you guys, if you know the word of God, to pray my strength during this journey, because it ain't easy. Like, I'm trying to do the right things in life right now, and I'm just trying to stay focused. I thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. Shout out to Anthony. I hope that you watched the whole video. You're the one that encouraged me to make this video in the first place of sharing my testimony. So thank you, Anthony, for the suggestion. I hope you enjoyed it. I would love to hear your testimony as well. So let me know if you start making YouTube videos. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and do not forget to subscribe and to tell someone else about my channel. Once I hit 1K, I will be doing lives here and there to do live and dream interpretation for you guys. So yeah, don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to tell others about this channel. I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.